broadcast live.
Shawty on mission, naughty. She wanna drink and party. She only drinks Bacardi. I got a lot of Bacardi. She wanna sit in a virus. She got a booty like Cardi. Diamonds on me, they shining. But I came up from nothing, yeah. Now I got a lot of Bacardi. Speedy, you know we got it, yeah. Falling in my heart. She is on my heart, yeah. So much.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to it. My name is DJ Speedsta. Welcome to the very first episode of my brand new show. It's called Speedsta In Da Park. As you can see, we are in the skate park. Big shout out to YBF for letting us use this skate park. I'm going to be having conversations with all kinds of people on the show. Basically, conversations that I can't have on my TV show, conversations that I can't have on my radio show. I'm going to be having them on this very show. It's going to happen once a month on Slicker On Live. So the show is basically about speaking to people that we don't speak to. So up and coming artists, people behind the scenes, whether it be designers, whether it be artists, whether it be managers. I think sometimes a lot of upcoming guys are trying to break into the game, and maybe they're tweeting their links and nobody's hearing their links, but maybe not speaking to the right people. There are some people that you don't know, which you're supposed to be speaking to, which you may be bumping in the club. So I'm going to be having those conversations with those people which are very important to the game. Like I said, whether it be fashion, whether it be art, whether it be music, this is the show. So warm welcome to all of you guys, the very, very first episode. And I thought it would be very, very special to get my real OG in here as the very first guest, a guy by the name of DJ Wandi. He's literally been in the forefront of this South African hip-hop thing. He's the founder of a brand called Loxion Kulca. You might know it. They're celebrating 20 years this year. So I thought it would be really, really cool to have him as my guest. So yeah, welcome to the show, and I hope you guys like it. One time. Thank you so much for taking time out your busy schedule to come and speak to me, man. This conversation was also supposed to happen like many years ago, but I'm glad it didn't. I'm glad it's happening right now, you know, just in terms of progress, because I think you've also seen the progress with me. For those of the people who don't know who DJ Wandi is, who yeah. Wandi is, please take them through it.
So who am I? I'm an entrepreneur. I'm a streetwear owner. I love hip hop. I've always loved hip hop. I've been collecting music for a long time, and one of the things that I wanted to do when I left school was to be a DJ, but you know, you have to work, you have to buy music, you have to buy equipment, and I didn't have that opportunity. So after I made quite a bit of money, I just followed that dream. I just wanted to be a DJ, yeah. And I've done that, and then over time, you know, working with a lot of celebrities, actors, I found myself in makeup rooms, in productions.
Yes.
And then I started.
Oh, is that how you got into TV now?
I started liking wardrobe, you know? From dressing Zola on Zola 7, Take 5, to Jam Alley, to backstage, you know? So I found myself, you know, watching what was happening. And I saw a different kind of expression, which was really about storytelling. Mm. And then I started working for production company in Randburg, Urban Brew Studios. Mm-hmm. In a very short space of time, I found myself producing shows like Live Amp, Real Corposa, you know, and then where you and I had our engagement, you know.
Soweto TV.
I just started falling in love with Soweto TV as a channel in terms of what it represented. And I saw it as a first, I think, on the continent, as a platform that basically represented a geographical area and a people and a mindset.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. So I like to express myself, but through work.
Yes.
You know, and I think the first piece of work that I expressed myself through was through fashion.
Yeah.
Because I grew up with fashion. My family used to sell secondhand clothing, which for me was punishment. Yo. I could never like chill and hang out with friends and skate and things like that as well. Every Saturday and Sunday, we were out selling secondhand clothing.
Yeah.
So I grew up with clothing and fashion, and I hated it.
Oh, wow.
You know, because it was punishment,
yeah.
You know? Or I saw it as punishment. So I knew from like early days that I was going to get into business.
20 years is no joke, you know, especially like you're saying, when you started, there were a lot of people who were laughing at you. There were a lot of people saying it is not possible, but here you are 20 years later. What was the module then? Were you trying to get the brand out through music? Were you trying to get the brand out through music videos? Were you trying to get the brand out through TV? You spoke about Zola 7 and backstage. Yeah. What was the module to get the Loxion Kulca brand out there? Maybe there's a young designer who's watching. He's really, really dope, but he just doesn't know how to get it out there. What was your module then?
I'll be very honest and say that there was no plan. You know, the other thing as well is that we were not trying to create a fashion label. We were just making clothes for ourselves, and people bought them off us. You know what I mean?
Nice.
So for me, when it comes to business, the very first thing is that you need to respect the fact that you are there to serve. And it's a service that you're providing. So we were just serving ourselves first. And by serving ourselves, our friends started liking what we were wearing. Some would steal it, some would buy it off us.
Yeah.
You know, one of my very good friends, Refiru Ramukhasi, used to buy probably about, 3 to 4 items every week.
Sure.
If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be so serious about it, because he's very difficult to please, and because he loved the brand so much, I knew that, you know, it wouldn't be difficult for us to sell the brand to anyone else. Yeah, so we dressed ourselves, our friends, our community, but our community was made up of producers,
cool
TV presenters,
cool kids.
And I think what we managed to do, and it's not a marketing strategy at all, we were dressing a movement. And it was
a serious
movement. It was Kwaito, it was the beginning of hip hop, but I think it was the beginning of most of us knowing that we can do it. But not only can we do it, but we can do it our own way. For me, that era just really signifies what is possible. And what we were doing was dressing that movement.
I remember that Jabba shirt, the legendary Jabba shirt. We had the cap like this. That was like the craziest time ever.
It was designed by Theo and Tape Lotispoon, you know? And they were doing the CD cover for Umang, which, if you remember, was an ID photo. And that image was so awesome that we actually pulled that out. And we put that on a t-shirt.
On a t-shirt.
One of the things that I promised Jabba on his birthday last year was that we have to fulfill what we had started, right? Which was, how then do we extend this to shoes? And you know how rappers are. He was jealous of Pro. Like, how come Pro has got a shoe and I don't, you know?
Yeah.
And then got worse when we made a shoe with JR. It was like, even Chad just got a shoe.
I still don't have a shoe.
Still don't have a shoe. After so many years. And also, I think the iconic thing is that we actually started at the same time as WHP. So when we met, we were all both young, you know, and we grew together. That's why last year for me, it was so painful, you know, to not only lose a friend, but to lose a peer, to lose someone that inspired me, you know. He likes to say he was inspired, you know, I inspire him. But, you know, he took on the world, man, you know. Yeah, but I think people can expect me to just show gratitude in terms of what he did for our brand by really launching the shoe as well.
I can imagine.
Yeah. She wanna drink and party. She only drinks Bacardi. I got a lot of Bacardi. She wanna sit. Broadcast live.